Hey, it's PeterGregg, Miami, Florida, straight from the news desk. I don't have a news desk. It's just you and me, okay? The big thing that happened this morning, and that was in relation to the Nikon Z6 Mark III was announced today. This is something that was eagerly awaited, meaning a lot of people were waiting for this camera to come out. What is taking them so long? So here's the short synopsis on the Z6 Mark III. The Z6 Mark III is exactly what it should have been, almost nothing missing. There's a couple of things. I'll get into that if I remember. But you take the Z9, and you have a Z8 that was created by Nikon, and it was called the baby Z9. It was basically the same thing as the Z9, and it was in a smaller body. It's got 8K in it. It's got all the highest technology that Nikon could put out, and it is in line with all the big flyers, okay? So the big flyers actually become important in this story. Because just in this room right now, the Christmas room, I've got a very high-end sensor-wise camera that you're looking at right now, which is the Sony equivalent to the FX3, the A7 Mark III. The A7S Mark III. That sensor, exact sensor, with no handicaps, is in the camera that you're looking at now. In a few minutes, we will switch automatically, because I'm the only guy here running this place, to a, we just switched over to a Fuji. So this is a 40 megapixel Fuji. So this would be a high-end Fuji camera, but it is a crop sensor camera. Eventually, we will switch over to a Canon R6 Mark II, which is their creme de la creme, without getting over the $3,000 mark of what's available for you and for me to buy. And then you've got Panasonic's S5 Mark II. So you've got all these high-end cameras. Let's just call them the $2,500 club, all right? And basically, what I want to do is I want to know what's going to give me what I'm looking for at that price range, because that becomes very important. And that's what I'm going to focus on. I could tell you right now, if you want what I would call the nerd edition, but I don't mean that in a bad way, I mean that in a good way, the best place you're going to get the information to dig down under the hood and check out what kind of screws and bolts does it use here versus over there, your best bet is to look at Gerald Undone, okay? I went there and I looked at him. I got all the information I needed right off of his video. So why should you watch this one, all right? The reason you should watch this one, I have a different point of view. So how about some of the basic stuff? I did take some notes, all right? The Z6 Mark III is Nikon's $2,500 club, which means this is the beginning of the professional level cameras from each camera company without handicaps, without, oh, we took this out and we took that out to bring you this price. So the Z6 Mark III is basically a Z8, but a baby form of it. They take out the 8K, leave most of the good stuff in there, and then all of a sudden you have a camera that fits right into the $2,500 club, which is what you're looking at right now. The Canon R6 Mark II is a $2,500 club camera. This is Canon's best offering at the $2,500 price before you move into the $4,000 price, okay, where they give you 8K. Some of them will give you lots and plenty of overheating and other kind of wonderful things. All right. Now, I'm looking at this as an event photographer. I'm a retired wedding photographer. So the price of this camera is $2,500. The sensor is a 24 megapixel sensor. This is all rounded out, okay? And the camera's supposed to hit the street, according to B&H, on June 25th, which is not far away, which is great. You don't have to wait a half a year for the camera to come out. As a matter of fact, if you look in the description below, I'll even have a link where on Adorama or B&H, you get your name on the list right quick, okay? And it gives you an advantage to use those links, and it gives me an advantage. You know how they start these videos? I don't have the camera here, okay? I have just what I've learned and my eyes on, no hands on, eyes on. But I'm using other people's eyes to interpret, would I want to buy this camera? So if you're a Nikon user, the answer to that is extremely simple. Yeah, this is the best Nikon you can get while staying out of the 8K world. Do you need 8K for video? All right, then you don't need to go to those $4,000 cameras. You actually can go into a more reasonable price, but you want all the stuff that that 8K camera will do, not only for video, but for pictures, which is critically important. So Woody, this is your camera. Woody is one of my listeners. He is a birding man, all right? So Nikon came out with the ZF. And then I have the ZFC, which is in my studios here. All right. They came out with the ZF. Now, the ZF left out certain parts. It's a $2,000 camera. All right. Now, those parts that they left out might be very critical and very important to a lot of people that are willing to go $2,000, but they're willing to go a few hundred dollars more to actually get the creme de la creme, the best you can get. This is it. This one too, okay? The Panasonic S5 Mark II. So there's very little difference between these $2,500 cameras, all right? But the thing is, Nikon has come to the table with theirs, all right? So let's go to some of the stuff that I find important. As a wedding photographer, you could interpret that as an event photographer, as of taking pictures or videos of your kids in sports, baseball, football, basketball, or if you're an event photographer that is not a wedding, all right, which means the camera has to be capable. This camera, the Z6 Mark III, on paper, is capable. Now, I said, you want to get under the hood? You want to get all into the nooks and the crannies? Go to Gerald's video. He's got it down. Now, the mic, it's got a mic plug. Headphone, it's got a headphone plug. This is basics, all right? Some of them are missing on some of these cameras. It's got a full HDMI. So a full HDMI is getting more critical. So the $2,500 club camera from Canon has a micro HDMI, all right? So if you're going to plug something into the camera, you're plugging into a plug that's going to break very quickly. This camera, the Z6 Mark III, full-size HDMI, full-size battery. As a matter of fact, same battery as the Z8. Remember, here's your key. This is what you could stop here. You like the Z8? This is a baby Z8. Take out the 8K, and you've got 99% of what the Z8 will do in the Z6 Mark III. This is exactly the camera they needed to come to the marketplace with, okay? It actually outdoes the R6 Mark II that you're looking at right now. This doesn't make this a bad camera. There is no bad cameras, but it's what it is that you're looking for. It's got the full-size battery. It's got autofocus at up to 20 frames per second, okay? It's got 3D tracking. 3D tracking, you know what that means? Let me just simplify it for you. It means it's tracking based on colors. Because when I was shooting weddings with my Nikon, 3D tracking came into existence. It was able to follow the red on someone's shirt. It was able to follow the white on the wedding dress or the tie on the groom, not just by trying to identify these things. It was taking it and adding the color. They call it 3D. It's looking, excuse me, at the dimensions, okay? So that becomes a very important of the ability. So if you're a wedding photographer, let me just make it very simple. This is the wedding camera that you need to use. This, especially if you're in Nikon, and if you're shopping across the board, this would be at the very top of your list, all right? Because it hits all the little spots, the check marks that you need to do. Now, what if you're a landscape photographer and that type of photographer? Well, it has pixel shift. Pixel shift means it's going to take 32 different pictures, shifting the pixels, and then outside the camera, not inside the camera, you're going to go to the Nikon software, and it will combine all of those pictures and make you a 96 megapixel image. So it does have to be on a tripod, where the Sony has taken it one step in advance, where you can hand hold it, but it can't be a moving object, okay? It still has to be a still object, all right? Now, how about on the video side? On the video side, it's basically on par with all the best of the best. In other words, Nikon has come to the game full on, all right? It's got the full internal RAW. It's got the flippy screen, which here's my Z6, not even the Z6 Mark II. It doesn't have the flippy screen, which means if I didn't want to buy a bunch of cameras and I wanted to do, where I would talk to you on the camera, I would be interested in a light camera. I'd be interested in a camera that can handle everything, but I'd also need to see myself. Now, the Nikon Z6 and the Z6 Mark II don't give you that, okay? On the Z6 Mark III, you get that. That's a big deal, all right? It's not, everybody wants to know about this and that. Well, you know, the ability to have the flippy screen so you can actually frame yourself, or you can go out there if you were going to pose somebody and you could look at your LCD while you're standing out there, they give you the flippy screen. That is a key feature. All right, the other key feature is on this camera that you're looking at now, which is about to change. I can get up to 60p full frame. There's no crop. It crops down to a 1.5, all right? This one does the same thing, full frame at 60p. Now, the other cameras in here that are full frame cameras, they will crop the 60p. The Z6 Mark III, the Z6 III, it does not crop. It goes all the way up to 60p at full frame. Now, where does it crop? When you go to the high speed, 120p, 120 frames per second, it will crop down to what they call DX mode, which is the 1.5 crop. All right, but it'll bring you back to full frame if you drop it down to 1080, which a lot of us don't shoot videos at 1080, but you can, okay? And it'll be almost full frame, and it will also allow you to be shooting at 5.4K. So there's a new word called open gate, which is confusing to people. Open gate basically means it's the entire size of the sensor. They came up with a word called open gate. Panasonic, years ago, they used to call it 6K mode. So what is open gate? On most cameras, it's 6K mode, okay? That means the camera is shooting at 6K and you have to crop it down to 16:9, 3:2, 9:16, 4:3, whatever the ratio it is that you're looking for, you do it. The camera's going to just shoot the whole shebang, okay? Now, when you go to 4K, like right now, you're actually looking at, 16:9. That is the standard YouTube and everybody tube 4K, 16:9, okay, for, the cinematic look and that type of thing. And then even when you get bars on top and bars on the bottom, those black, and it looks like it's super wide, it's because they're cutting out the top and they're cutting out the bottom. Okay, so it will give you that at 5.4K, which is a good thing where some people are trying to make it a bad thing. So this camera has everything that I would be looking for salt, pepper, garlic, the three main things for when you're seasoning, okay? It'll do in camera raw, okay? And it'll do NRAW and ProRes. And the only other camera that will actually do this at this point is the new GH7, which is a winner, winner, chicken dinner camera, but it's Micro Four Thirds, okay? What is it missing if you're a video guy? All right, it's missing shutter angle. Now, the good news is that's something that can be added. The bad news, why isn't it there? Okay, but when they do a firmware update, you might be looking for that, all right? So the autofocus sensitivity on this is like all the other top of the lines. It'll do the birds, animals, planes, trains, throw the mama under the train, that kind of stuff, okay? Now, you guys that are into event photography for pictures and maybe even for video, one of the things that the Z6 has addressed that other cameras don't specifically address, and it's actually a key thing for me, I'm very much into skin tones. Skin tones are key, all right, because a lot of wedding pictures, portrait pictures, even kids, pictures of my kids, all right, my daughter, my son, who's got tons of acne, okay, I'm interested in the skin tones, all right? So they have specifically targeted skin tones on the Nikon. Even my older Z6 Mark Nothing, this is the original Z6. I still use it here right now. I took it out of circulation to put this Fuji XH2 on here, all right, so that I'm able to show you the Fuji for the Fuji lovers, all right? But this still gives me one of the best skins. So the Nikon has put that in the Z6 II. They put that in the ZF, but they even took it farther on the Z6 III, all right? So you really got a humdinger of a winner on the camera, all right? It's hard to say another camera like the one that I've got right now. I would say I like it, but it has the overheating problem, not in the studio, all right, but maybe out on the street. I have been able to overcome it, but I'm guessing most of you would not. All right, now, stack sensor. Stack sensor technology means you got a sensor, all right, and it takes a picture, and you got to get all the pixels, all the image off of that sensor, okay? So there's a number of different ways to do it. The basic way that you and I know is it starts from the top and it reads across all the way to the bottom, one and done, okay? Then they came in with a backside illuminated. All that means is they took all the wiring between all the pixels and they put it on the back of the sensor. So now there's more room for pixels and all the wiring is on the back of the pixels, which becomes important. Important for a number of reasons. Heat is an important thing. So this is backsided illuminated. Then they came up with what is called a stack sensor. This is a sensor and then another one behind it, but it doesn't have pixels. The wiring has been moved over to the second part of that sensor. So now the sensor is two parts. The wiring is on this part, and all the photo stuff is on this side, okay? That's called a stack sensor. So this has got a partial stack sensor, which, when you think about it, is a little bit ingenious, okay? So it is a stack sensor in the sense that it takes the very top and the very bottom, okay, and it moved it over to that second piece. But the middle still stays on the backside illumination of the original, the main part of the sensor. So what that does is it speeds it up, it reduces rolling shutter, it reduces heat, and it reduces price because you don't have the two full plates that it takes to make one single sensor. So it's a partial stack sensor. Actually pretty cool when you think about it, right? So if you have the Nikon mentality, this is your replacement for the D850. You guys are going like, there's just no camera that replaces the D850. Well, there is now, the Z6 Mark III. The Z6 Mark III took everything that's left out of all the little pieces that Nikon has circled, you know, the campfire and given you cameras, the ZF, the Z6 II, and the different models, and moved way up here with the Z8, all right, at $4,000, but we have an open hole. The open gate technology? Well, Nikon has been dealing with an open hole technology. Nothing fits into that $2,500 where everything you need basically is in the camera. And now they've plugged the hole. So you guys that are wedding photographers, this camera meets everything, okay? All right, you guys that are birding photographers, this camera is your camera. Take the Z8, everything you loved about it, except the price, and that you're never going to shoot 8K. So why should you pay $4,000? Take out the 8K, and you basically got the whole shebang in the Z6 III. All right, now, one of the things that Gerald only that I have noticed has mentioned is two items that are kind of key, and that is the overheating. He mentions he got zero overheating, okay? He did get overheating when he shot 120p for like a half hour. And if you're shooting 120p for a half hour, God bless you. There's something wrong between this ear and this ear. You don't shoot 100, you don't shoot slow motion for a half hour, okay? And if you do, it's not your camera. You need a camera with a fan built in. All right. But the other part that was very, very important, which you're not going to hear most places, is the camera kind of implies that it has something called dual ISO. So what's dual ISO? That means at ISO 400, 640, 800, you get a really darn clean pictures on these $2,500 cameras. As you start to go up, it gets noisier. All right. Well, is there a spot where it suddenly reverts back to the cleanliness, the dynamic range, all the beauty that you had? Let's say I'll pick the middle one, ISO 640. So that's just above ISO 400 and right below ISO 800. So that's kind of like the middle. Well, he notices it does. At ISO 5000, you have a very noisy picture on the Z6 III. But if it goes to ISO 6400, bam, you're suddenly back to ISO 400 cleanliness. So you could shoot at a wedding with some 1.8 lenses, and you could be shooting at ISO 6400, and it'll be as clean as if you were shooting at ISO 6 at 400 or 640. That's key if you're working in heavy, low light. The other major thing with low light guys, okay, is, you know, when you put a flash unit on here, years ago, the flash unit emitted a red light. They called it an infrared light. Was it infrared? No, but just for the sake of talking. And the camera was able to focus in pitch, pitch black because it would transmit a non-seeable to the eye red infrared light. Well, the Z6 III took special attention to actually upping the focusing part of the camera to be a different ISO than the imaging part, meaning it'll take it up to ISO 50,000 to get you a very good, sharp, very fast focus picture and still take your picture at ISO 6400, okay? So this actually takes the camera and makes it a killer in low light. And it works, yes, for photography, and it works, yes, from what I understand. Okay, it works, yes, for photography, and yes, for video. So if you're an event photographer, or you like to shoot in restaurants, or you like to shoot in very low light out in the street at night and stuff, this camera has a built-in feature to get you the focusing sharp and instant because it bypasses what the sensor is going to record and uses a separate algorithm for the focusing. All right, so these are key features. Bottom line, the camera is a super winner. I probably will wind up with one here. Skin technology, full-size HDMI, key points. Dual ISO, meaning I can go in killer low light and get great pictures. Excellent, okay? That's very key for me. It takes third-party lenses without the rigmarole that Canon puts you through, okay? Canon puts you through no third-party lenses. Now they're heralding it that they're opening it up to third parties, but the part they're leaving out is it's going to cost you. Somebody's going to pay for that licensing. It's going to be you, and it's going to be me, okay? So they just kind of ignore that part. That's bad boy Canon, all right? So you've got Viltrox here. You've got Sigma. You've got Tamron. They all make these Z-mount lenses for the Z. So this is the creme de la creme of the Nikon sweet spot camera. You want to go higher? Go to $4,000. Get the Z8. You've got the top of the line. Okay? But you don't need all of that. And you don't need to spend the $4,000. The $2,500 club is going to be the sweet spot. And now Nikon has got a champion right on the top. Now, if you want to get into more nuts and bolts, go to Gerald Dundon's video. I mean, it's going to be, he's nerdy. Okay, and I'm not saying he's a good guy. I'm not saying he's a bad guy. I'm just saying that's where I get the details that I'm looking for. Like, is it a full-size HDMI? It's important to me. I don't want to have to ship the camera out to get that fixed. Gerald will tell you that, okay? And a lot of other little things, like the dual ISO at 6400 is almost clean. It just cleans up the image. Where an ISO 5000, yuck, okay? That's the kind of stuff you'll get over at Gerald's. And I don't know Gerald. Gerald doesn't pay me anything, unfortunately, to push his site. All these wonderful things. This is an honest review and everything else these guys go through. This is my opinion. Either take it or leave it. I don't give a crap, all right? So PeterGregg, Miami, Florida, we have a wonderful winner with the Z6 Mark III. Use my link to pre-order because those guys that get on that list now using my links are going to be at the head of the class. So it does help me, okay? And yeah, I get a commission. That's the one thing they don't tell you. Oh, I got this camera. I didn't get any money from it. They're not giving me the camera. This is an honest review. Bull hockey. Okay, I get a commission when you use my link. And I'm going to be up front, but that doesn't affect anything. All right, because either I'm going to buy the camera for myself or I'm not. And this camera, going to buy it for myself. It's got my mark of approval. It fits. It does it right. It's hardly missing anything. What's it missing? Shutter angle. But I already spoke about that. Back up, you'll see where I said something about shutter angle. I love you guys. Thank you for being here. PeterGregg, Miami, Florida. Catch you later. Bye. Whoosh.